Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the concept quadrilateral. Okay, already we have seen midpoint theorem, we have seen some problems on midpoint theorem. Again we are going to see some problems on the same concept because this concept is very much important. Okay, so see carefully. Today's first problem is, in triangle ABC, AB is the median through A and E is the midpoint of AD. BE produced meets AC in F. Prove that AF is equal to 1 by 3 AC. AF is equal to 1 by 3 AC. Okay. Once again, see in triangle ABC is given here. AD is the median through A. AD is median through A. Okay. AD is the median of BC. Definitely AD and BC are equal. And E is the median, E is the midpoint of AD. This is the midpoint, means AE and AD are equal. Okay. BE produced meets AC in F. BE produced meets AC in F. Okay. Prove that AF is equal to, half of 1 by 3 of AC. Okay, so here we need to use midpoint here. Okay, so directly we cannot do, cannot solve this. We need to do some construction. Okay, so what we are going to do? We are going to construct the parallel line from point B. Okay, parallel line for which? For BF. Okay, so draw a parallel line for BF. Okay, which will intersect. So this is D and here we can use any name. So DK is parallel to BF. DK is parallel to BF. Okay. So here we need to mention, draw DK parallel to BF. DK parallel to BF. Okay. So now here see BF and DK are parallel. BF and DK are parallel to each other. That means EF and DK are parallel. EF, so we can say from this, we can say EF is parallel to DK. EF is parallel to DK. Okay, we have seen midpoint theorem. Okay, midpoint theorem, according to midpoint theorem, we can say here EF is equal to 1 by 3 of DK. Okay, 1 by 3 of DK. When it is possible? When lines are parallel. Okay, this line segment which is joining midpoints of two sides of a triangle. So EF is parallel to DK. So definitely F is the midpoint of AK. Okay, F is the midpoint of AK because EF is parallel to DK. So we can write here F is the midpoint of AK, and E is the midpoint that is given. E is the midpoint of AD, that is given. This is given. F is the midpoint of AK. We said because of this, EF is parallel to DK, so F is the midpoint of AK. So from this, we can say AF is equal to FK. AF and FK are equal. AF is equal to FK. So this is, I am saying first. Okay, AF and FK are equal. Okay, so now we are going to think about next triangle, that is BFBC. Okay, in triangle FBC, here see EK, this BF is parallel to DK. BF is parallel to DK. Okay, BF and DK are parallel. So definitely K is the midpoint of FC. K is the midpoint of FC. K is the midpoint of FC. So we can say FK is equal to EC. FK and KC are equal. FK and KC are equal. So this is, I am saying, second. Okay, so now if I want to write AC, AC is equal to AC is equal to AF plus FK plus KC. AF and FK plus KC. Okay. But AF is equal to FK and FK is equal to KC. Okay. Means all the three segments, that is all the three line segments, AF, FK and KC are same. Okay. So we can write, instead of this, we can write AF plus AF plus AF is equal to AC. Okay. So here AC is equal to 3 times AF. So AF is equal to 1 by 3 AC. 1 by 3 of AC. Okay. And that would be, they are asking to prove AF is equal to 1 by 3 of AC. Got it, everybody? Very simple question. Okay, see here, our second problem is, in a triangle ABC, find the measures of the angles of the triangle formed by joining the midpoints of the sides of the triangle. Okay, see, figure is given, triangle ABC is given. Okay, only triangle ABC is given. This midpoints we have taken, D, E, F. Okay, D is the midpoint of BC. F is the midpoint of AB and E is the midpoint of AC. Okay, so midpoint means EC and EA are equal. So in short, here we are going to use midpoint theorem. Okay, so first in solution we will write here in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, E, D, F are the midpoints, midpoints of AC, of sides AC, then second D is CB and AB respectively. Okay, these are the midpoints. Okay. So according to the midpoint theorem, ED is parallel to AB. Okay, ED is parallel to AB. So ED is parallel to AB. Then ED is parallel to AB. EF is parallel to CB. EF is parallel to CB. And EF is parallel to CB. And last one is, third side is, FD is parallel to AC. And FD is parallel to AC. Okay, so according to the midpoint theorem, we can consider this. Okay, so now here we have to find out, in a triangle ABC, find the measures of the angles of the triangle formed by joining the midpoints of the sides of the triangle. So means here we have to find out this angle, these angles. Okay, a triangle which is formed by the midpoints of the given triangle. Okay, so here we have to find out angle F, D and E about triangle FD. Okay, so that is our target, that those angles we need to find out. Okay, so now first we will consider here, this is, if when ED, first we will consider this. Now ED is parallel to AB. ED is parallel to AB. Okay, ED and AB are parallel and CA and CB are the transverse. Okay, ED and AB, ED is parallel to AB, CA and CB are the transverses. Okay, so when two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, that time corresponding angles are equal. So that we are going to use. Okay, AD, see carefully, ED and AB are parallel to each other, and CB and CA are the transversal. So definitely this angle will be as same as angle B. So this is angle B. Okay, this is angle B, as well as this angle CED will be angle E, corresponding angle. Okay, corresponding. Now three times ED, we have considered ED is parallel to AB. So we got here CED is equal to angle A, CDE is equal to angle B. Okay, so here we can make angle CDE, angle CDE is equal to angle B, and angle CED is equal to angle D. Okay, so this we have considered, this is first. Now we will take this EF. Now EF is parallel to CB. EF is parallel to CB. Okay, EF is parallel to CB. Now AC and AB are the transversal. AC and AB are the transversals. AC and AB are the transversals. Okay, so now see carefully, EF and CB are parallel. EF and CB are parallel. These two are parallel. Okay, now we have to consider this. This is angle, these two are parallel. So this angle C. So definitely this angle will be C corresponding. Okay, now this angle is C and this angle is equal to B. Okay, this and this angle will be same. So this is angle B. So here we can mention angle ACF, angle AEF, angle AEF is equal to angle C, and angle AFE, angle AFE is equal to angle B. Okay, so this we have taken from this, when EF is parallel to CB, that one. Now we will use third thing, that is FD is parallel to AC. FD is parallel to AC. FD and AC are parallel. Okay, that then BC and EB are the transversal. BC and AB are the transversals. Okay, see carefully, which we have taken FD and AC, FD and AC. Okay, so this angle will be, this is angle C, so this is going to come angle C. Okay, this will be angle C, and this angle will be angle A. This is angle A. Okay, so we can mention that is FDB, angle FDB is equal to angle C, and DFB, angle DFB is equal to angle A. Okay, so this is first, this is second, and this is third. Okay, now we will consider here C. We will think about AC. AC is a straight line, or AC, AB and CD are the straight lines. AC, AB and CD are the straight lines. Okay, straight line means what we will do here? Angle A plus this DEF plus C is equal to 180. Okay, so that we are going to do, because these three angles are forming linear straight line. Okay, so here I am taking that angle A, here direct here AC line, angle A plus angle DEF, angle DEF plus angle C is equal to 180. Okay, so now angle DEF we will keep here only. DEF is equal to 180 minus angle A plus angle C. Angle A plus C, it will move that side, and 180 minus angle A plus angle C. But 180 we can replace. 180 we can replace by angle A plus B plus C, because the sum of three angles of AD triangle is 180. So that instead of 180 we are going to take angle A plus angle B plus angle C. Now we will remove this bracket, angle A minus angle C, minus angle C. Okay, so from that A and this will be cancelled, minus C and plus C will be cancelled. So what is going to remain here? Angle DEF is equal to angle B. DEF is equal to angle B. Okay, so now this is, we have taken AC line. Now we will think about AB. Okay, so we got here DEF is equal to angle B. Second thing we will use now, AB. AB is also straight line. So B plus A, angle B, angle B plus angle A plus EFB, angle EFB is equal to 180. Is equal to 180. Okay. So now after this, what we can do? EFB we will keep here only. Angle EFB is equal to 180 minus angle B plus A. Angle B plus angle A. Okay. So 180 we will replace by 180. Instead of 180, we will take angle EFD is equal to 180. Again, we will use the same thing, angle A plus angle B plus angle C minus angle B minus angle A. Okay, so A, B will be cancelled. So angle EFD is equal to angle, you see, angle C. EFD is equal to angle C. EFD is equal to angle C. Okay, so this we got angle C. EFD is equal to angle C. Okay, now one more is remaining, that we will see. Next line is BC. BC is also a straight line. So in that, angle B plus C, angle B plus angle C plus angle EDF, angle EDF is equal to 180. Okay, so angle EDF is equal to 180, we will replace by angle A plus angle B plus angle C minus, this B plus C will go that side, that is minus angle B minus angle C. So B and C will be cancelled. So angle EDF is equal to angle A. EDF is equal to angle A. Okay. So these are three angles which they are asking in the question. Okay, see here, our next problem is, this sum is for NCERT. Okay, see here, in figure ABCD is a trapezium in which side AB is parallel to side BC and E is the midpoint of side AD. E is the midpoint of side AD. If F is a point on the side BC such that segment EF is parallel to side BC, prove that F is the midpoint of BC and EF is equal to half of AB plus BC. Okay, two things they are asking. One side is C. In figure ABCD is a trapezium. A trapezium is given. ABCD is a trapezium in which sides AB is parallel to side BC. Side AB, AB and DC. We know that this is one of the property of trapezium. Okay, AB and DC are parallel to each other. And E is the midpoint of side AD. E is the midpoint of side AD. E and AD. Okay, midpoint of side AD. If F is a point on the side BC, F is a point on the side BC such that segment EF is parallel to side BC. EF is parallel to BC. Okay, one thing we have here. AB is parallel to DC and EF is parallel to DC. This all the three lines are parallel to each other. Prove that F is the midpoint of DC and EF is equal to half of AB plus DC. Okay, two things there are. So first we will mention here given. So given, in given, ABCD is a trapezium. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to BC. AB is parallel to BC and E is the midpoint of side AD. Okay, E is the midpoint is the midpoint of AD, is the midpoint of AD. If F is a point on the side BC such that segment EF is parallel to side DC, EF is parallel to BC, this is also given. Through that, F is the midpoint of BC and EF is equal to half of AB plus DC. So, to prove is that EF is equal to half of AB plus DC. AB plus DC. Okay. So, this here they are asking prove that F is the midpoint of BC. That will come automatically. Without that, we cannot prove this. EF is equal to half of AB plus DC. Okay. So, now we will move towards the proof. So, in proof, okay, see here, what is given? AB is parallel to DC. AB is parallel to DC. And EF is also parallel to DC. Okay, what is given? AB. AB is parallel to DC. And EF is parallel to DC. EF is also parallel to DC. Okay, so if EF is parallel to DC, then EG is also parallel to DC. EG is also parallel to DC. EG is parallel to DC. Okay, here it is given that E is the midpoint of AD. That is given. But if EG and BC are parallel, then G is also midpoint of AC. Okay, so here we can say directly G is the midpoint of AC. Okay. E we will not mention because it is already given. E is the midpoint of AD and G is the midpoint of AC. Why G is the midpoint? Here EG and DC are parallel. Okay, if these two lines are parallel, E is the midpoint. Okay, so we can say G is also midpoint according to the midpoint theorem. So EG is parallel to DC, we have taken, so G is the midpoint. Okay, so we can say according to the midpoint theorem, we can say EG is equal to half of DC. EG is equal to half of DC. Okay. So now this is our first. Now we will see about this. What they are asking? EF. EF is what? EF is EG plus GF. Okay. So first, now we have EG. Now we will try to find out GF. Okay. So first we need to decide. GF directly we cannot use. We need to decide that F is the midpoint of DC. Okay, so that is also very easy. EF is parallel to DC. This is given. EF is parallel to DC. That is given. If EF is parallel, then we can say GF is parallel to the DC. Okay, and DC is parallel to AB. DC is parallel to AB. That is given. DC is parallel to AB. So we can say GF is parallel to AB. GF and AB are parallel. So F is the midpoint of BC. So F is the midpoint of BC. F is the midpoint of BC. Okay. If F is the midpoint of BC, we can say G is the midpoint of BC. That already we have given here. F is the midpoint of BC. So according to the midpoint theorem, we can say GF is equal to half of A. GF is equal to half of A. Okay, so this is second thing. And we have to find out EF. EF is what? EG plus GF. EG is here and GF is here. Okay, so by adding 1 and 2, we will get the whatever they are asking that. Okay, so EG. So from first and second, EG plus GF is equal to half of BC plus half of AB. Okay, EG plus GF is equal to EF. EF is equal to half, we can take common, half of BC plus AB. Half of BC plus AB. Okay, and that would be the other thing. EF is equal to half of AB plus BC. Here, BC plus AB is same. Okay, so this is the proof of this example. Okay.